Hey, I'm going to take two programs. One is simple Hello World program and other is introduction to data type and variables. Let's see. Let's create a project. Command line tool. And let's give a name. Let's say cbasics. Okay, I'm going to create here. See, the procedure might be different in different IDs, but yeah, it will be similar. You will be able to create an .c file. You can give any name other than this main or main, anything. Okay, and you have to save with .c extension. Here this file is auto generated. Okay, this is a simple Hello World program. It already created for us, so let's run. Okay, you can see here in the product there is a run, so it will automatically build and will give output for us. So this is the console. Yeah, so yes, we got. What's our target is to print Hello World on the screen. Okay, we already got it, but how? Let's find out that. You can see this is the program, but here there are many lines. Okay, so first this, when a line starts with this slash, double slash, right? So these are all we say as a comments. These are all ignored by the compiler, so this won't appear on the our output screen, this console, right? This is to give an extra information, who wrote, when wrote this file, etc. Okay, so for now this is not required, so I'm going to remove this comments. Okay, and yeah, this is something not required for now too. Okay, so let's understand this. You can see right here this Hello World, okay, in the code here. So let's start from here only. Okay, so in the double code you can see this, and here is a printf. So printf is a function which prints whatever provided to it under the double code on the screen. So here under the double code we said that yes, print Hello World. So it printed this. And what is this? Slashing. Slashing means new line. After the this word, go to the next line. Okay. So if you want to be more clear, I'm removing this slashing and I'm providing here. So what happens is hello, then comma, and then slashing and word and some two dots will be get printed, right? You want to see? Let's run it. Command R to run it. So hello world. Okay, good. So whatever we see inside this, the printf will print that on the console. Easy, right? So but what are the other lines? See, always remember the execution of the R program start from the main. So whenever we if this main is not there, then the linker will throw an error that it is not able to find the main. Okay, so execution start with main. Main is a, as you can see, this is a round bracket, you can see here also. So the main is a function, and when you see this curly brackets, right, we say that this is a body. So whatever the statements that are inside this body are will be executed. Every statement, this is one statement, this is one. Okay, and as we have a full stop in our normal language, every statement ends with semicolon here. Okay, so main is a function. Before the function name, we have to provide what it returns. So it returns a zero. Zero means a successful execution. So we printed this hello world, our program is done successfully, so we are returning this zero. That's why here the console said that your program ended with execute zero. From where it is returning? From this main function. Okay, so zero in the C, the numbers are represented with a data type integer, so we say that returning type int. Okay, that is we are returning a number. Cool, that's it. So main is a function, so this is return type, main is a function name from where execution starts. This is how we represent the function. And then in the curly braces, this is the body. Whatever the statements inside it will be executed. Printf is the function. Whatever we say inside it, it will print on the console. And this is the return 0. That means the program is executed successfully and we are returning 0. Okay. But what is this line? So this printf, where it is coming from, we have to give the reference from where it is coming from, so that it get while executing the object file will be get from that reference. So the printf is declared in this header file, stdio, that is standard input output header file, and we are saying include that, okay, so that we can use this printf. That's it, simple, right? So let's start with the next program. That is, if you have any doubts, then please comment. Okay. New target, and let's create next. Let's say data type and variable. Okay. So as you can see, a new file .c file is automatically generated. I'm not using this. Not required. Not required. So let's understand what is this data type and variable. Okay, in the maths you have seen, right? You say like in the school, okay, while studying, we in the many problems we said that assume x equals to something 1, and then we did something calculation, and then we said that, right, x equals to some x and plus 10. What this? So yeah, it is incremented with value and this, and then some calculation, and then finally we said that yes, the value of x is now this, right? So see, 1, 10, these are the constants, right? The value of it can't change any time, but while doing some calculation or while processing, we need something that the value of which can change automatically depending on the conditions and something, right? So here we say assume x, that is x is a variable. In the R program also we want this feature, right? So in the how this is achieved, yeah, you can see in the program x equals to 10. When you say this, let's say this is a memory, okay, old memory, some memory will be saved, and equals to 1, right, means the value of 1 will be saved here, and this memory you can use this and using the x variable x. So whenever you say x, then value in this memory will be accessed, okay? Yeah, I say then you said x plus 10, right? So whatever the value inside this x is this memory, means 1. So add 10 to it, means it becomes 11. So whenever you say x, means value 11 you will get, right? Cool. But I said some memory, but how much memory, how it will get to know how much memory to save, right? So that is specified using the data type. So there are data types, I can show you here. There is a char is for storing the character, single character. It is of size 1. Then there is a int. There are types of int, short int, long int. Yeah, you can see this. And float, double. This is for real numbers like 3.7, float, double, and long double. And integer is for whole numbers like 6, 7, etc. Okay, void means nothing. Okay. So how much memory we say by using this data type? Let's see in the directly program, okay, how we are doing this. So in the program, as we discussed, we say int x equals to 1. What this does is 4 bytes of a memory is saved. There 1 is the 1 value is saved over there, and we can refer that memory using the x, okay, and then we can print the value of this. How you will print? You have to give some placeholder, this is said as a format specifiers, and then yeah, you can print anything what you want. and then you can say as x. What this means is that we want to print whatever we want, then we want to print percent %d. Percent %d means whatever I specify next, put the value of that variable over here. Okay, cool. So here what you will get is, oh, we have to change the target. Okay, cool. So here as you can see, okay, let me put slash in here, sorry, slash in, that's it. So you can see the value of this variable 1 we got, okay, as output here, and this is the placeholder that actually puts the value of variable inside it. Now let's say x equals to x plus 10, okay, as we discussed, right? So what should it do? The value of the x, that is 1, it should add 10 to it. Okay, so what will the value of now? 11, right? Yeah, I want to print this value, then something again I want to print. You can print again, right? So but yeah, you have to provide it here. It says that yeah, you have given this more %d, but you are not using, right? So yes, we have to, this means here replace with this 6, but here with what you can again give, right? However you want, you can print. Okay, then yeah, the value of x you got, the value of x you got, and then you can have more variables too. Let's say y equals to 2, and I want to say as x equals to x plus y, means value of x is 1, value of y is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 will be saved in the x. Okay, so the output will be 3 3. Cool. Now what will the value of y? Let's see, it should be 2 only, right? We are not changing it. 3 2. Cool. So you got what is data type, what is variable, right, and how to print hello world on the screen. Cool.